criticism of one sovereign state or the case made out by the other state must be in language consistent with the dignity of sovereign states and the majesty of this court and the solemnity of the proceedings in this court. Humpty Dumpty has no place in this court. This court has jurisdiction over sovereign states and conducts proceedings in which sovereign states are given directions which are binding upon them. This court therefore conducts itself with restraint and respect, which does not undermine the sovereignty of any of the states or shows disrespect towards any of them. The language which has echoed in this court, sir, in these hallowed precincts, is "and so that such misadventures are not repeated, perhaps this court may, in counsel's word, lay down some red lines of how proceedings ought to be conducted." The transcript is peppered with words such as shameless, nonsensical, laughable, breathtaking arrogance. On a quick count, shameless and nonsense occur 5 times each, arrogance 4 times, ridiculous 4 times, and disgraceful 4 times. And these are addressed to the submissions made in the memorial in the reply by the Sovereign Republic of India. India takes exception to being addressed in this fashion in an international court. Beyond saying this, I would let the matter rest, for I do not, and the Indian culture prevents me from, indulging in similar language of invectives and insults. India believes we have a strong case, and so we have, sir, as the saying is, hammered the facts and hammered the law. As the old lawyer saying goes, when you're strong on the law, you hammer the law. If you're strong on the facts, you hammer the facts. And when you have neither on your side, you hammer the table. Bereft of a case, Pakistan has hammered the proverbial table.